We're told that Mika can eat 21 hot dogs in 66 minutes. She wants to know how many minutes, M, would it take her to eat 35 hot dogs if she can keep up the same pace. So a big clue is the same pace. I didn't have to remove a hair from my tongue, all right. a big clue is the same pace. That means that the hot dogs per minute is going to be constant, is always going to be the same. Always the same. Because this is essentially the pace. Her hot dogs per minute are going to stay the same. She's going to stay at the same pace. So it tells us that she can eat 21 hot dogs in 66 minutes. So her hot dogs per minute, at least up here, it's 21 hot dogs in 66 minutes. So it's 21 hot dogs in 66 minutes. Well, if her pace is always going to be the same, well, it's going to take her, this ratio over here is going to be the ratio between 35 hot dogs and however long it takes her to eat 35 hot dogs. So once again, hot dogs per minute has to be a constant because it's going to be the same pace. Hot dogs per minute. If it takes 21 hot dogs takes 66 minutes, 35 hot dogs take M minutes, these two ratios are going to be the same. We're dealing with a proportional relationship. That's going to be happening at the same rate. And then we're left with a situation where we just have to solve for M. And there's a bunch of different ways that you could tackle this. The easiest way that I can think of doing it is, I don't like this M sitting here in the denominator, so let's multiply both sides by M. Let me do that in a different color. So if I multiply that side by M, and then this side by M. And so what do we get? On the left-hand side, we have 21 over 66M. 21 over 66 times M is equal to, well, you divide by M and multiply by M. Those are going to cancel out. And you're just going to have 35. And now you just have to solve for M. And the best way I can think of doing that is multiply both sides times the reciprocal on both sides times the reciprocal of the coefficient on the M. So let's multiply both sides by 66 over 21. Once again, I've just swapped the numerator and the denominator here to get the reciprocal, but I can't just do it to one side of an equation. I have to do it to both sides. Otherwise, it's not going to be an equation. It's not going to be equal anymore. So times 66 over 21. This is just going to be 1. You multiply something times its reciprocal, you're just going to end up with 1. So you're going to be left with M is equal to, now 35 times 66 divided by 21. Well, 35 is the same thing as 35 is 5 times 7, and 21 is 3 times 7. So you're multiplying by 7 up here, and here you have a 7 in the denominator. You're dividing by 7, so they're going to cancel out. So this is going to simplify to 5 times 66 over 3, and then we could simplify it even more. Because 66 is the same thing as 3 times 22. 3 times 22. And so you have a 3 in the numerator, you're multiplying by 3, and a 3 in the denominator, you're dividing by 3. 3 divided by 3 is 1. So you're left with 5 times 22, which is 110. So it would take her M minutes to eat 35 hot dogs at the same pace. Now, when some of you might have tackled it, you might have had a different equation set up here. Instead of thinking of hot dogs per minute, you might have thought about minutes per hot dog. And so in that situation, if you thought in terms of minutes per hot dog, you might have said, okay, look, it took Mika 66 minutes to eat 21 hot dogs, and it's going to take her M minutes to eat 35 hot dogs. And if it's the same pace, then these two rates are going to be equal. They have to be the same pace. And so then you can solve for M. And actually, this one's easier to solve for M. You just multiply both sides by 35. Multiply both sides by 35. And you're left with, on the right-hand side, you're left with just an M. And on the left-hand side, same idea. You're taking 35. You have 35 times 66 21sts, which we already figured out is 110. So 110 is equal to M. So once again, multiple ways to tackle it, but it's important that we got the same answer.